Hello student, you are watching Akshar Education Educational Channel and we are studying about laws of motion. In previous video we have seen velocity time graph for uniform acceleration. Today we are going to see equation of motion using graphical method. गतीची समीकरण आलेखाच्या सहाय्याने आपण समजून घेणार आहोत. न्यूटन स्टडीड मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट अँड गेव अ सेट ऑफ थ्री इक्वेशन्स ऑफ मोशन. न्यूटन स्टडीड मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट अँड ही गेव सेट ऑफ थ्री इक्वेशन्स ऑफ मोशन्स. How many equations? Three equations of motions. In these three equations, he gives the relation between displacement, velocity, acceleration, time of an object moving in a straight line. Suppose any object is moving in a straight line. In that case, he gave the relation of the displacement of an object to the velocity, to the acceleration, to the timing. And according to that, he stated three equations of motions. Now, suppose an object is in a motion. An object is in a motion along a straight line. Object is in a motion along a straight line. Suppose this is an object moving in a straight line. Now some things about it, some physical quantities about it. As the object is starting from the first point, at that place the initial velocity of an object, suppose it is a u, that object is changing its velocity. Okay, if it is in a moving object would change its velocity due to acceleration. That acceleration is A. Objects start moving. Acceleration A is there in the object. Then in time T, the displacement of object would be S. And the final velocity of an object is a v. So object is moving in a straight line with the initial velocity u, acceleration a in time t, displacement is a s there, and the final velocity is a v there. According to all these three equations of motion can be written as, the first equation v is equal to u plus at, second equation is s is equal to ut plus 1 of at square, and third equation is a v square is equal to u square plus twice as. Now in the first equation, there is a relation between velocity and timing. There is a relation between velocity and timing. The first equation is in the relation of velocity and time. In second equation, where we are going to find out the displacement, so the equation is S is equal to ut plus 1 of at square is related with S and t, that is the displacement and timing. And the third equation, where we can find the final velocity, is v square is equal to u square plus twice as. And this equation is relation between the velocity and displacement. So these are three equations which is given by Newton, and these three equations are of motions. These are written as it, and the relation between every equation is given here. So for all these three equations, we have to find, we have to study about the graphical representation of each equation. Newton ने गतिमान असलेल्या वस्तूचा अभ्यास करून गतिविषयक समीकरणांचा एक संच तयार केला, तीन गतिविषयक समीकरणांचा. याच्यामध्ये डिस्प्लेसमेंट स्थानांतरण, वेलॉसिटी वेग, एक्सेलरेशन त्वरण, टाइम वेळ यांचा विचार केला, की ज्यामध्ये वस्तू एका सरळ रेषेत गतिमान असताना त्याचं डिस्प्लेसमेंट, त्याची वेलॉसिटी, त्याचं एक्सेलरेशन, त्यासाठी लागलेलं टायमिंग यांचा विचार केला, किंवा यांच्याशी संबंधित ही तीन इक्वेशन आहेत. सपोज एखादी ऑब्जेक्ट स्ट्रेट लाईन मध्ये मूव्हिंग होते, त्याची इनिशियल वेलॉसिटी यू आहे, एक्सेलरेशन ए आलेलं आहे, टायमिंग टी घेतलेलं आहे आणि डिस्प्लेसमेंट एस झालेलं आहे आणि फायनल वेलॉसिटी व्ही असताना ही तीन इक्वेशन्स कशी लिहिली आहेत? V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus 1 of at square, and v square is equal to u square plus twice as. The first equation is a relation between velocity and time. Velocity and time are the relation. The second equation is a relation between displacement and time. Displacement and time are the relation. And third equation is a relation between velocity and displacement. That is the HMA, velocity and displacement are the relation. संबंध आहे. ओके, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द ग्राफिकल मेथड ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन्स. ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द ग्राफिकल मेथड ऑफ इक्वेशन डिस्क्राइबिंग द रिलेशन बिटवीन वेलॉसिटी एंड टाइम, दैट इज वी इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस एट, दैट इज द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ अ मोशन. Now suppose one of the object is moving in a straight line. Okay. And it starts from D and reaches to B. From D it starts with initial velocity u and it reaches to B at a final velocity v. And displacement is a BD, that is DB. Okay, for that displacement, object take a timing T, that is OE. OE is the timing, T is the timing. So this graph is showing the change in the velocity. This is the change. This one is, this is the quantity of a initial velocity and this is the quantity of a final velocity. On y-axis we are showing velocity and on x-axis we are showing timing. So this is change in velocity. This is initial velocity, this is final velocity. Graph shows the change in velocity with the time of a uniformly accelerated object. Acceleration is uniform there. Be careful. Vegatla badale to uniform hai, ek sarka hai. The object start from point D with initial velocity u. Its velocity keeps increasing. Velocity vadat challe, and in time t it reaches to B with the final velocity v. Now we are coming to each and every step. Here initial velocity is a u, that is the OD. OD is the initial velocity. This height shows the initial velocity, which indicated by u. Final velocity, the final velocity on v, x, y axis is a v, that is by segmental representation it is a OC. Initial velocity is a OD and final velocity is a OC. So v is equal to OC, u is equal to OD. Time taken for displacement is a t, that is a OE. Displacement is a dB, that is x. And in that, the acceleration is a, which is change in velocity per time, that is a v minus u upon t. So v is a OC minus OD upon t. OC minus OD, that is full OC, minus OD, that is become CD. So acceleration is a CD upon T. Acceleration is A. A is equal to CD upon T. So we are taking T on other side of equal sign. Equal sign, that is a CD is equal to, like said, A is equal to CD upon T, therefore CD is equal to T is coming here by transformation. So CD becomes AT, that is the first equation. Now here we are going to see about the velocity change. With the help of this BE, this is the velocity change. Here once again we can observe the velocity change because we are plotting DA parallel to x axis and BE parallel to y axis. So according to that we can find out the velocity changes, that is the final velocity, that is the V. So first of all BE is equal to what? BA plus E, that is BA, that is CD, plus AE, that is OD. So BE is equal to BA plus AE, that is CD plus OD. Is it clear? So BE is equal to, from the graph, BE is equal to AB plus AE. So AB plus AE, that is CD plus OD. Clear? So velocity changes is CD plus OD because this is the velocity. Now what is about CD? In first equation we have seen that CD is equal to AT. So I am putting AT at the place of CD. So AT plus U. Change its place, only place is changing. V is equal to u plus at, and that is the graphical representation of first law of motion. Ya tikani object cha velocity change hotana cha graph aplyala dakavlaya ahe. Ti object kashi ahe? Uniform acceleration madhe, ek saman korna madhe ahe. D ya bindu pasun nikaleli ahe. Prarambhicha veg u ahe. Velocity vadat gelele, veg vadat gelela ahe. T timing nantar ti object B ya tikani pochlele ahe. Tyavela final velocity v ahe. Mati chip सुरुवातीचा वेग प्रारंभीचा वेग u हा ओळीने दाखवते नंतरचा वेग v बरोबर v हा नंतरचा वेग आहे तो कशात दाखवते ओसीने दाखवते जो टाइमिंग लागलेला आहे तो ओई आहे एवढा टाइमिंग मध्ये गेलेले आहे त्यामुळे आम्हाला तो ओईने दाखवते तो t आहे डिस्प्लेसमेंट त्याच्यामध्ये dv घडून आलेले आणि यासाठी एक्सेलरेशन झाले ते आम्हाला किती मिळते एक्सेलरेशन त्वरण किती मिळते तर वेग बदलाचा दर v - u / t सो oc / oc - od / t oc - oc - od दैट इज cd / t या t या ठिकाणी आपण काय केलं क्रॉस करून इथे मल्टीप्लाय केलं म्हणजे cd = 18 दैट इज द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन आता फ्रॉम ग्राफ वेलोसिटी इकडे पण आपल्याला प्लॉट करतोय येऊ शकते कशी येते बघा v इज इक्वल टू va प्लस ae va प्लस ae म्हणजे cd प्लस co प्लस म्हणजे oc प्लस cd प्लस od cd प्लस od cd प्लस od ab प्लस ae दॅट इज cd प्लस od बरोबर आहे ab प्लस ae च्या जागेवर मी काय लिहिलं cd प्लस od लिहिलं cd मीन्स व्हाट 80 80 OD म्हणजे काय आहे OD OD इज अ U आता फक्त प्लेस चेंज केली V इज इक्वल टू U प्लस 80 एंड दैट इज द ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ ओके नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब द इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन which describing the relation between displacement and time. That is the equation is s is equal to ut plus 1 of at square. Here once again we are going to take a object which is in a uniform acceleration a. Object is in a uniform acceleration a. It covers that object covers distance s. Okay, in timing t. Now from the graph we are going to calculate the displacement s covered in a timing t. How we can calculate it? By the formula of areas. That is the quadrangle ODBE. That is the quadrangle which shows the displacement. So displacement can be calculated or given by the area of the quadrangle DOEB. So area of a quadrangle DOEB consists area of a rectangle DOEA plus area of a triangle DAB. These two figures, first figure and second figure. This is the area of a rectangle. This is the area of triangle. So we are going to add in the area of a rectangle. That is which rectangle? DOEA. This one. This one. So area of a rectangle is a length into breadth. That is OD into AD. So OD is a U. U into DA. That is OE. That is the timing. So U into T plus 1/2 into DA is a T timing. This is the timing into CD because AB is equal to CD. So I am putting CD at the place of AB. But we are knowing about CD. CD is equal to 80. In the previous equation, we have seen that. So S is equal to U into T, that is UT plus 1/2 T into at the place of CD, there is 80. So 80 will एक बिहाइंड द टी. सो एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस वन हाफ ए टी इंटू टी दैट इज टी स्क्वेर. सो एस इज इक्वल टू यू टी प्लस वन हाफ ए टी स्क्वेर एंड दैट इज द सेकंड इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन गिवन बाय न्यूटन. एंड वी आर गोइंग टू से अबाउट द थर्ड इक्वेशन. इन द सेकंड इक्वेशन we have calculated the displacement by using the formula of a quadrangle DOEB, and in that case we have added the rectangle and the triangle. But one more thing, that this quadrangle is a trapezium, so we can find out the displacement by using the formula of a quadrangle DOEB. So what is the formula of quadrangle DOEB? Formula of a quadrangle, that is the trapezium. Area of a trapezium is a sum of parallel sides. One half into sum of parallel sides into height. That is the displacement by the area of a trapezium, DOEB. That is displacement is equal to one half into sum of parallel sides into height. So sum of parallel sides, one half into parallel sides. This is the trapezium. This is the trapezium. So parallel sides are OD and BE. OD plus BE into height is a DA. This is the height. So OD is a U plus BE is a final velocity, that is V. That is OC. B is a OC, that is V. So OD plus B is a U plus V. We can write V plus U also. Into DA is a timing, T. So displacement comes, displacement is equal to 1 up into U plus V into T. Now, we are knowing about acceleration. A is equal to V minus U upon T. So we are taking T here and A on this side. So it becomes, timing becomes V minus U upon A. Now put the value of a T in above equation here. So what will be the equation? S is equal to 1 half into V plus U into, at the place of T we are putting V minus U upon A. So the equation will be S is equal to V plus U upon 2 into V minus U upon A. So product of these two, that is 2A. So it become 2A will come to multiplying, that is S. So 2A into S, that is 2As, and here it is V plus U, V minus U, that is A plus B, A minus B, A square minus B square. By this formula it becomes V square minus U square. So taking only U square on this side, and the equation would be V square is equal to U square plus twice As, and that is the third law of motion. That is the graphical representation of third law of motion. हे तिसऱ्या लॉचं ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन आहे. व्हिडिओ व्यवस्थित लक्ष देऊन ऐका, शेवटपर्यंत ऐका. पूर्ण ऐकल्यानंतर तुमच्या लक्षात येईल तिन्ही ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन तुम्हाला छान कळलेले असतील. आवडला असेल निश्चित आवडणार आहे, लाईक करा, शेअर करा, इतर मित्रांना शेअर करा, चॅनलला सबस्क्राईब करा, म्हणजे तुम्हाला 10वी पर्यंतचे व्हिडिओ मिळत जातील. मी 10वीचे व्हिडिओ तयार करतोय, म्हणजे तुमचा 2 वर्षाच्या अभ्यासाची सोय होईल. हा पाठ अभ्यासताना प्लेलिस्ट अभ्यासायचे, प्लेलिस्ट. चॅनलवर गेला की तुम्हाला प्लेलिस्ट मिळते, प्लेलिस्ट वर गेला की तुम्ही या पाठाची प्लेलिस्ट काढायची, आणि पहिल्या व्हिडिओ पासून या व्हिडिओ पर्यंत सहज पाठ गेला की तुम्हाला तो पाठ अगदी व्यवस्थित समजतील. फळ्यावर लिहिताना मी तुमच्या बुक्स मधल्या सगळ्या नोट्स लिहिलेले आहेत, कारण काही जणांच्याकडे बुक्स नाहीत म्हणून. सो कीप युअर स्टडी ऑन. हॅव अ गुड डे.